Good afternoon, students. In 12th standard, there are 15 chapters. 8th one is respiration and circulation. So today we are going to start the part circulation. In that part, first there are contents like blood vascular systems, types of blood vascular systems. Single circulation, double circulation, circulatory system in human, composition of blood, plasma, erythrocytes, leukocytes, types of leukocytes, thrombocytes, blood clotting or coagulation. Next. In higher animals, the circulation is carried out by a special tube, blood and lymph, blood vascular system. Higher animals from Annelida to Chordata have a special circulating tube, the blood, which pumped to the tissues by the heart through the blood vessels. There are two types of blood vascular systems. First one is open system of circulation. And second is closed system of circulation. In this system, that is open system of circulation, the blood is pumped by the heart through large vessels into the cavities called sinuses. On the other hand, in the closed system of circulation, blood is pumped by the heart through a closed network of vessels. Open system, the blood tissues are in direct contact with blood. In closed system, the blood tissues are not in direct contact with blood. In open system, blood flows at low pressure, hence it is a slower and less efficient system in circulation. While closed system, blood flows at high pressure, hence it is a faster and more efficient system of circulation. In open system, the flow of blood is not regulated through the tissues and organs, while in closed system, the flow of blood can be regulated by walls. This system is present in arthropods and molluscs, and closed system of circulation is present in annelids, echinoderms and vertebrates. In closed system, again, there are two types. That is a single circulation and double circulation. In single circulation, the blood passes through heart only once during each cycle as in fish. Deoxygenated blood is pumped from the heart towards the gills, where it undergoes oxygenation, that is a purification. This oxygenated blood moves towards the various parts of the body, where it again gets deoxygenated and return back to the heart for the next cycle. Since the heart of fish carries only deoxygenated blood, it is called venous heart. In double circulation, blood passes through the heart twice during each cycle, as in birds and mammals. So, deoxygenated blood from all body parts, it is carried by superior and inferior vena cava. It is poured into the right atrium, then it passes to the right ventricle. It is carried by pulmonary artery to the lungs for the purification, and purified blood is carried by pulmonary vein. It is poured into the left atrium, then to the left ventricle. It is carried by dorsal aorta to the different body organs. So in double circulation, heart pumps deoxygenated blood to the lungs for oxygenation and returns to the heart as oxygenated blood. This is pulmonary circulation. Whereas the oxygenated blood is pumped from the heart towards various parts except lungs and returns back to the heart as a deoxygenated blood. This is called as a systemic circulation. Human circulatory system. The human circulatory system is composed of blood vascular system and lymphatic system. Again, blood vascular system in human being, it consists of blood, heart and blood vessels. This blood vascular system is responsible for various functions like transport, homeostasis and protection. Next, blood. So first term is, that is the hematology. Heme means blood and logos means to study. So hematology is a study of blood. Next, in an adult, average range of blood is 4 to 6 liter. The color of blood is red. It's a connective tissue derived from embryonic mesoderm. Blood is slightly alkaline in nature. Its pH is 7.4. It is a salty and viscous fluid. It is heavier than water. So composition of blood. Blood is composed of 55% of plasma and 45% of blood cells, also called as a blood corpuscles. So content of plasma we will see in details in next slide. Blood corpuscles or blood cells, they are of three types: red blood cells, white blood cell and platelets. So next, composition of plasma. Plasma is a colorless viscous fluid. It shows 90% of water, 7 to 8% of proteins, that is the albumin, globulin, troponin, growth hormone and fibrinogen. 1% of inorganic salts like sodium, potassium, magnesium, calcium, iron, manganese, chlorides, bicarbonates and phosphates. 1 to 2% other materials like food, including glucose, amino acids, fatty acids and triglycerides. Waste substances like urea, uric acid and creatinine. Regulators like hormones, enzymes and vitamins. Anticoagulants like heparin, cholesterol and antibodies, and dissolved gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Next, that is the erythrocyte. It is also called as a red blood cells. So erythrocytes are the most abundant in cells in the human body. RBCs are circular, biconcave and enucleated, that is a nucleus is absent except in camel and ilma. So it is also belonging to family of camel. So RBCs are red in color due to an oxygen carrying pigment, that is the hemoglobin, in their cytoplasm. In males, average number is about 5.1 to 5.8 millions per cubic millimeter, while in female it is about 4.3 to 5.2 million per cubic millimeter. This is the total RBC count. Average lifespan of RBC is 120 days. The process of formation of RBCs is called as a erythropoiesis. The erythropoietic organ of the fetus is liver and spleen, and in adult it is mainly red bone marrow. So vitamin B12, folic acid and heme proteins are required for the production of RBCs. Condition with increasing number of RBCs is called as a polycythemia, and decreasing number of RBCs than normal is called as a erythrocytopenia. The hormone erythropoietin produced by kidney cells stimulates the bone marrow for the production of RBCs. Erythrocytes are responsible for the transport of respiratory gases like O2 and CO2, maintains pH and viscosity of blood. They also contribute in the process of blood clotting. The hemocrete is the ratio of volume of RBCs to total volume of blood. It is different for men and women. Leukocytes, that is the WBCs. WBCs are colorless, nucleated, amoeboid cells larger than RBCs. Due to their amoeboid movement, they can move out of the capillary walls by a process called as diapedesis. A normal adult has an average 5,000 to 11,000 WBCs per cubic millimeter of blood. Decreasing number of WBCs less than 4,000 is called as a leukopenia, common in HIV, AIDS, and TB patients or those who exposed to radiations, shock, etc. Temporary increase in number of WBC is called as a leukocytosis. It is due to infection. But uncontrolled increase in number of WBCs is a type of blood cancer called as a leukemia. WBCs are mainly concerned with defense mechanism, that is a protection. Next, types of WBCs. So there are two main types of WBCs, that is granulocytes, as the name suggests, cytoplasm contains granules, and in agranulocytes, cytoplasm shows no granules. So there are three types, that is the eosinophils or acidophils, basophils and neutrophils. So first, that is the eosinophils. They are about 3% of total WBCs. Their cytoplasmic granules are stained with acidic stain, that is the eosin. The nucleus is bilobed. They are non-phagocytic in nature, and they have antihistamine property. So second type, that is the basophil, 0.5% of total WBC. Next, it shows granules stained with basic stain, that is the methylene blue. It is a twisted or S shape. It is a non-phagocytic and they are having a anticoagulant properties and inflammatory responses. Third type, that is the neutrophils. It is a major WBC. About 65 to 70% of total WBCs stained with neutral dyes, and nucleus is 3 to 5 lobe. It is a phagocytic in nature and it kills pathogen and cellular debris. On the other hand, agranulocytes, it shows two main types, that is the lymphocyte and monocytes. In this, cells are larger and a nucleus is also larger. So lymphocytes, they are large round nucleus. They are about 30% of total WBCs and they produce specific immunity cells, that B cells produce antibodies, T cells destroys cancer and virus infected cells. Next, that is the monocyte. They are large, shows kidney shaped nucleus. It contains about 3 to 9% of total WBCs. So they become macrophages that phagocytize pathogens and cellular debris. So this slide shows a percentage of agranular sites and granular sites, just we have discussed. Next one, that is the thrombocytes. It is also called as a platelets. Thrombocytes are cellular fragments formed from the large cells called as a megakaryocytes. Mega means big, karyon, that is the nucleus. These are produced in bone marrow. They are very small, oval-shaped cells fragments without nucleus. Normal count of thrombocyte in human blood is about 2.5 to 4.5 lakh per cubic millimeter of blood. If the number of thrombocytes decreases than the normal, this condition is called as thrombocytopenia. This condition causes internal bleeding, that is the hemorrhage. Platelet secretes platelet factors, which are essential in blood clotting. They also seal the ruptured blood vessels by formation of platelet plug, that is thrombus. They secrete serotonin, a local vasoconstrictor. In last slide, that is the ब्लड क्लॉटिंग और कोएगुलेशन ऑफ ब्लड. क्लॉटिंग और कोएगुलेशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ कन्वर्टिंग द लिक्विड ब्लड इनटू सॉलिड फॉर्म. दिस प्रोसेस मे बी इनिशिएटेड बाय कॉन्टैक्ट ऑफ ब्लड विथ एनी फॉरेन सरफेस दैट इज द इंट्रिंसिक प्रोसेस और विथ डैमेज्ड टिश्यू दैट इज द एक्सट्रिंसिक प्रोसेस. इंट्रिंसिक एंड एक्सट्रिंसिक processes involve interaction of various substances called as a clotting factors by a stepwise manner. There are in all 12 clotting factors membered as first to 12. Factor 6 is not in active use. Interaction of these factors in a cascade manner leads to the formation of the enzyme thrombin. Thromboplastin helps in the formation of enzyme prothrombinase. This enzyme inactivates prothrombin. This enzyme inactivates heparin and it also converts inactive prothrombin into active thrombin. Next, thrombin converts fibrinogen into soluble blood protein fibrinogen into insoluble fibrin. Fibrin forms a mesh in which platelets and other blood cells are trapped to form the clot. So this diagram shows the blood clotting or coagulation of blood. So in next lecture we will see the structure of heart, internal structure of heart.